When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through you? Well, we're giving them to you. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street, USA.
Wasn't it Robert Fulton who said, life is like a train? No, it wasn't. He said, life is like a boat.
Wasn't it Isaac Newton who said, life is like a train? No, it wasn't. He said, life is like an apple.
Wasn't it Lord Chesterfield who said, life is like a train? No, it wasn't. He said, life is like a coat.
Then who said it? Who said it?
We did. We did. Ha, ha, ha. Ho, ho, ho. Life is like a train. Life is like a train. And aren't we lucky to be making the ride together? Life is like a train.
Like a train,
life is like a train, life is like a train, life is like a train, life is
not like an apple,
life is like a train, life is
like a train,
life is like a train, life is like a train, life is like a T,
life is like an R,
life is like an
A,
life is like an
R,
and life is like a train, life is not a boat. Life is like a train. Life is not a boat.
Life is like a train. 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 Life is like a train.
Life is like a train.
Life is like a train. Life is like a train.
At the end of the tunnel, there's always something new round the bend. But this is our philosophy, and this it shall remain.
Life is
like a train. Life is like a train. Life is like a train. Life is like a train.
And if life is like a train, it is roaring from Broadway to Main Street. Hello, this is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, and today we're going to celebrate one of, if not in fact, my favorite show, yes, folks, on the 20th century, that streamlined Art Deco juggernaut of a romantic musical that zoomed to Broadway in the 1978-79 season. Score by Comden and Green, and Cy Coleman writing a terrific music, directed by Hal Prince, and starring, what for me, were two tremendous performances by John Cullum and Madeline Kahn. And the reason we are bringing it back to the track, as it were, is a revival of the show, which has not been seen on Broadway since 1979, has streamlined its way to the Roundabout Theater, starring the one and only Kristin Chenoweth, wonderfully matched with Peter Gallagher, and it's a huge, whopping hit. And by and large, all the reviews not only praised the show and the design and the direction and the cast, but said, as it must be said, that it is one of the most glamorous, exciting, and ambitious Broadway scores, certainly in the musical comedy territory. So we are going to go through most of the original cast album today. Normally I don't do that, but it's never really been covered. We have a couple surprises along the way, but I hope you'll enjoy the score as much as I do and as much as I have since I saw it in its out-of-town tryout in Boston, which was about to be covered by a huge four-day avalanche, I think in January of 1978. We'll get back to that. Our story begins in Chicago, where theatrical impresario Oscar Jaffe has staged a flop show, one of a recent string of disasters, and he and his press manager and his managing director need to escape from Chicago before the mob tracks them down and ties them to a stake and burns them. And how are they going to get out of Chicago to New York? The one and only way, that Art Deco streamlined express, the 20th century, which leaves from Union Station to New York. So here is the opening number from the original cast of On the 20th Century.
Saddle up the horse without delay. Ship ahoy, we sail at break of day. Ours not to question, ours not to reason, ours to obey.
Back at the hotel, I'll keep busy at the desk.
I'll sneak the bags out the back. Right. Let down the drawbridge while you keep the motor racing. Maybe we'll have to swim the river. Working for Jaffe, though continually bracing, also destroys the heart and liver. What's new today? We're gonna sneak away through a shower of rotten eggs with our tails between our legs on the 20th century, the 20th century. In drawing room, hey, 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 hey.
Points with the deepest pride to the grandest ride on the New York Central Railroad, the aristocrat of locomotive trains. New York is 16 hours. Anything can happen in those 16 hours on that mighty ride, the mighty miracle of engineering. Ride on 19. Is it still on the 20th century? America, the beautiful rose bride. On the 20th century, on the 20th century, on the luxury liner between NY and Time. Life and love and luck may be changed. Hope renewed and fate rearranged. On the 20th century,
And as that luxury liner pulls out of Chicago, the two friends are wondering what happened to their third musketeer, Oscar Jaffe. And he sneaks onto the train, and they tell him that he's ruined and he's got to get out of town. And he says, but he has a plan. And his great plan is to be reunited on this 16-hour train ride with Lily Garland, the love of his life, the actress who he made into a star back on Broadway. So here is John Cullum to express the indomitable spirit of Oscar Jaffe.
Traitors! Look at the two of you, Judas Iscariot and his sister Sue. You think I'm finished? They all think I'm finished. Every time they think I'm through, I rise again, full size again, and give those doubting Thomases a walloping surprise again. I sneer at them, I jeer at them, I thumb my nose and bite my thumb and bear my royal rear at them. With my back up against the wall, with the wolves yapping at my heels,
with a noose tightening round my neck. That's the time I know how really living feels, with the wall up against my back, with the water rising to my chin, chained and bound tight inside a sack. That's the plight that I'm delighted in, for I have powers like Aladdin's genie did. I do escape tricks better than Houdini did. In the black of my cul-de-sac, do I crack and fall? No! I attack with my back up against the wall.
Listen, boss, you gotta use your brain. Everyone you owe will meet the train.
I shine again. All is mine again. A fighter rising from the canvas at the count of nine.
The count is ten. You're out. The drums of doom are knocking. Your theater and your offices, the bankers will be locking.
I split at them, spray flit at them. I'll face those grim Goliaths with my slingshot, and I'll hit at them with my back up against the wall. Angry birds pecking with their beaks, or submerged, sealed inside a tomb. That challenge brings the roses to my cheeks. So rally round me, my musketeering men. We'll turn that raging lynch mob into cheering men. From the false reports of my demise, like the phoenix right before their eyes, with my back up against the wall, I rise again. I rise again.
Now, among adapted musicals, On the 20th Century had a real theatrical provenance. It began as a play in the early 30s called Napoleon of Broadway, and then was adapted by Hecton MacArthur, who had written the front page, as 20th Century. And that original production in 1932-33 started Moffat Johnson and Eugenie Leontovich, who, well, they were big stars back then, but it wasn't until 1934 when Howard Hawks made it into a movie with John Barrymore and Carol Lombard that it became the stellar granddaddy of all great screwball comedies. The musical was created largely as a vehicle for Madeline Kahn, who in the early 70s had become this great comedian in all of Mel Brooks's movies and Academy Award nominee for Paper Moon. And she did a couple of Broadway shows, Two by Two, and a tiny part in 1970. But here she was firmly affixed as the comedic star of On the 20th Century. I thought she was fantastic. And here is a flashback number where John Cullum as Oscar Jaffe discovers this meek little pianist named Mildred Plotka might have some star wattage after all. Madeline Kahn and On the 20th Century.
Pardon me, but I'll be late. Gotta catch my subway train. Pardon me, thanks a lot, but Mr. Jaffe, you're insane. Pardon me. See, I got my folks. What I earn pays the rent. Pardon me. Thanks a lot. But Mr. Jaffe, I'm content.
Uh-huh.
Did you really think I could do this?
Yeah. Begin reading.
Veronique, she wink an eye. Veronique, the bullets fly. Veronique, she close her door and start the Franco-Prussian War. Veronique, the femme fatale. Veronique, the fleur de mal. Veronique, 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 Veronique.
Veronique, 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 Veronique.
Veronique, she wink an eye, Veronique, the bullets fly, Veronique, she close her door and start the Franco-Prussian war. Veronique, the femme fatale, Veronique, the fleur de mel, Veronique, shut Bismarck out and make the population shout, save our city. Let old Bismarck have a look. Save our Paris. You'll look good in history book. Ah, but Veronique won't let him have a peek. Paris falling. Boom! 1 week!
Veronique.
She snap a fan, Veronique. She make a plan, Veronique. I save the town, but I don't. Veronique, shout, kill the Boche. Suddenly a shot, then two, and she fall lifeless down la rue. But her spirit dances on above the fray. Liberté, égalité, fraternité, France is saved, and freedom once again can speak, all because of Veronique! Veronique, 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 Veronique! Ah! She saved the town, she don't lie down. She turns the tide with fiery pride. Vive la France!
A pair of lovers. desert.
Safe on our planet made only for two.
Night after night,
night after
day
night,
after day, day after day. Living a private two-character play. Here
great love ballad from On the 20th Century, where Oscar Jaffe and the newly christened Lily Garland remember what life used to be before she became a big star. Beautiful song, rarely covered, maybe one or two jazz albums or something covered it. But we are celebrating the score to On the 20th Century today on Broadway to Main Street because it is thundering back in a revival at the American Airlines Theater, produced by the Roundabout Theater Company. So let's enjoy this show. Well, one of the stowaways, as it were, on this 16-hour train ride is an heiress named Letitia Primrose of Primrose's Restorative Pills. But it turns out, as played in the original cast by Imogen Coca, that she has a secret of her own, which is that, well, she's a nut.
Across the night, America, the beautiful rolls by. All those windows, all those people, all those lives. Across the land, in every home, in humble hut or pleasure dome, I know there's dirty doings going on. The man who seeks, the fancy whore, the boy who locks the bathroom door. Ah, yes, I know, dirty doings going on. And I must spread the word and save you from your fate. You must mend your ways before it's too late. Repent, repent, repent. Stop those dirty little doings, every man and boy and wife. Repent, repent, repent. Stop those wicked little wooings that are screwing up your life. Walk the narrow path, my friends, and keep your thinking pure. Try to lift your minds, my friends, a notch above the sewer. Repent, repent, repent. Reform, reform, reform. Take a nice icy shower when you're feeling
warm. In every town we're passing through, beneath a bush, inside the zoo.
I know there's dirty doings going on. The devil tempts us every day. The backseat of a Chevrolet could be the place dirty doings going on. So heed the simple rule to save you from your doom. Do only what you do with mother in the room. Repent, repent, repent. In the fiery pits of Hades, it's too late for your laments. Repent, repent, repent. There's a fiery pit for ladies and a fiery pit for gents. Now's the time to choose, my friends, the afterlife you'll fit. Waltzing on a cloud, my friends, or turning on a spit. Repent, repent, repent. Join the angel band. Repent, 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 for the time is at hand. Like you, I once was wild. Men shouted, oh, you kid, a life of shame I led, and dirty doings did. Until one night I saw the light and heard salvation's call. I'm so glad I didn't hear.
till I did it all.
Repent, though sinning may seem swell. Reform, recant, return, renounce. Repent or go to hell.
Imogene Coca from On the 20th Century. I love the way Mary Louise Wilson plays the part in the current revival at the Roundabout. Well, as I said earlier, I saw this show in its out-of-town tryout in Boston, and I thought it was simply the greatest thing I had ever seen. I've seen it since twice in New York, London. I love this show. I remember in Boston during intermission, the couple in front of me turned around and said, "Sir, would you mind not enjoying it so much? You're ruining it for the rest of us." And that has been, ever since that moment, I've always wanted to enjoy shows as much as possible. Anyway, this is Larry Mazlon, your host from Broadway to Main Street. And also I remember seeing in Boston a young actor named Kevin Klein, who had made his big Broadway musical debut as Lily Garland's Hollywood dumbbell boyfriend named Bruce Granite. And here is a duet that Cullum sings with Kevin Klein, where they are jockeying for position to see who will woo Lily Garland the best. Both gentlemen won Tony Awards. Here they are, John Cullum, and at the beginning of a stellar career, Kevin Klein.
The mirror tells me she's mine.
The mirror tells me she'll be mine again. Your flashing wit,
your flashing eyes,
your brilliant brain,
your brutal thighs.
These are the tools you've got at your command
to make her mine,
to keep her mine,
to make her mine.
Your crooked smile,
your inner fire
that spells romance,
that sparks desire.
Cuddly, crunchy,
you've got what the ladies cry for.
Crafty, cunning,
you are what they gladly die for.
Talent, genius,
you're the stuff that dreams are made of.
Hey, man lover, what have you to be afraid of? What have you to be afraid of? You're almost perfect, but one thing is true. You need her desperately, but she does not need you.
She runs the show.
She runs the show.
She leads the band.
She leads the band.
The royal flush.
The royal flush
is in her hand.
Is in her hand.
Face it, old boy, you can't afford to fail.
Must not fail.
Dare not fail. Will not fail.
So flash that wit,
and flash those eyes,
and use that brain,
and use those thighs.
Hey, team, hey, team, break right through the line. There is no stronger challenge than an independent woman.
You can do it,
you can do it.
Got to keep her,
got to make her mine.
Oh, give them both Tony Awards. What? You did? Fantastic. This is Larry Mazlon, your host for Broadway to Main Street, and today we are all aboard for On the 20th Century. Now, our current revival began when Kristin Chenoweth sang an amazingly adept Comden and Green and Julie Stein song called If from Two on the Isle for her debut album. Supposedly Comden and Green said, you know, one day you should play Lily Garland in On the 20th Century. So let us go to the song that Kristin Chenoweth sang that inspired these light bulbs above Comden and Green's very intelligent heads. If, sung by Kristin Chenoweth.
I really don't know what to do about him. I've told myself I've got to do without him. I've got to do this, I guess. Goodbye, Joe. From here I kiss you. Goodbye, Joe. I hope I don't miss you.
If you had been on the square and had treated me fair and we'd not had a tiff, if you had not said I should go and jump right off the nearest cliff, if you had stayed off the make and you'd never have taken to coming home stiff, if I had not smelled perfume with a nasty, unfamiliar whiff, I'm gonna miss you, baby. Things could have been terrific. Now, what's the diff? If you had not had the cheek to stay out for a week, saying back in a jiff, if you were not such a two-timing guy, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, but you haven't, you weren't, you went and you didn't, so goodbye. If I had not seen you take Geraldine on the lake in your flat-bottom skiff, if you were not that with Sue with your arms around her bare midriff, if I had not seen you pen sexy letters to Gwen in your own hieroglyph, if you would not left me home when you had two seats for South Pacific, I'm gonna miss you, baby. You were too darn prolific. What's the diff? If you were not such a hound who when game was around always picked up the sniff, if you were not such a two-timing guy, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, but you weren't, you haven't, you when you did, and so timing guy, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, but you hadn't, then we coulda and you didn't, though you shoulda, if you didn't, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, but you weren't, you haven't, you went and you didn't.
Well, that's obviously not from On the 20th Century, but it sure is Kristin Chenoweth, and she gives a performance for the ages there on 42nd Street at the American Airlines Theater in the current revival. And since this show is so cherished by all of you, and we try to give you great surprises, here is an exclusive cut with Kristin Chenoweth and Peter Gallagher, her opposite number in On the 20th Century, singing the great showdown from On the 20th Century towards the end of the first act. You heard it here first, folks. I've Got It All with Kristin Chenoweth and Peter Gallagher.
My life is simply great. My silverware is gold. Through my Bel Air estate, champagne's a flowing river. Next to my Rolls Royce, a Cadillac's a flavor. I'm in clover, and my cup, it runneth over. Footprints on the wet concrete. My hometown now has a lily garden street. I am mocked by fans who faint and shriek my name. The price of fame. Look at you and me, the sweetest story told. I'm high as I can be. You're lying in an alley. Trill me round her voice. She got a neat friend. You've got nothing and I've got it all. Forgive my lack of tact, but here's the basic facts. You've got nothing and I've got it all.
Are you finished?
No, you are. Chauffeur, butler, cook.
You're spoiled.
They're foreign and they're old.
You're
the reputation soiled, a billion shop girls a few. Nightly nationwide, a billion farmhands rape you.
Please stop trying. What you'd like to sell me, I'm not buying. Don't come at me with a contract. I will not sign any contract.
Contract, contract, who said contract? Did you hear me mention contract? I came here with a dream we shared once long ago. Two hearts with one grand scheme.
Don't you know when something is over?
This was a professional dream. The role that you were made for. A role, a chance to play. That Bernhardt would have paid for.
Save your breath. Don't even try. Back again with you. I'd rather die.
Perhaps it's just as well. I've seen you on the screen. On stage you wove a spell. With each new play it deepened. But now your art is gone. It's coarsened and it's cheapened. Since you rolled out, since you sold out to cheap Hollywood. Sleazy, cheesy Hollywood. Pitiful, cityful of celluloid slime.
Oh, you're jealous!
Vermin-vested, vermin-infested. Home of freaks and cheeks and geeks and celluloid crime.
Sour grapes.
Playing foolish parts, every part the same. Morons who direct, crucify your name. Lily on display, just a bargain sale. Lily, face the truth. Lily, you've gone stale.
Stale?
Another stale cheap dolly from cheap, cheap Holly.
My life is simply great. My silverware is gold. Through my Bel Air estate, champagne's a flowing river. Look at my Rolls Royce.
Oh, Lily, you've gone stale.
The movie public's choice.
That's not the Holy Grail.
All the biggest names in town are begging to be asked to dinner.
Give them all a year or so, they'll drop you for the latest winner.
Did it by myself.
Keep your tainted
got health. Got there by myself.
Headed for the shelf.
Never needed
Lily,
you.
Lily, you are through.
I'm a winner.
You're a loser.
I'm not buying.
Tragic story, lost your glory.
Some Spengali in an alley.
Shop girls ape you, farmhands rape you.
I've got it.
You've lost it.
I've got it.
You've lost it.
I've got it.
You've lost it.
I've got it.
You've lost it. Cheap Hollywood.
I've got it all.
Cheap Hollywood.
I've got it all.
You've lost it.
A sneak preview, weeks before the cast album comes out, of the revival of On the 20th Century. Well, let us go back to the original cast from 1978. Mrs. Primrose, played by Imogen Coca, has agreed at the last minute to underwrite Oscar Jaffe's next epic, which will star Lily Garland as Mary Magdalene on Broadway. So here is the original cast celebrating their success with a big old whopping check.
One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five zeros. Preceded by a two, preceded by a dollar sign, is two. Oh, 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 oh. Wonderful for words. Hello, old friend. Hello, Mr. Money, you've been away so long. Pull up a chair, put up your feet. Hello, old friend, we've missed you, Mr. Money. So stick around, don't leave us, 'cause when you are here, we eat. Five zeros. Preceded by a two,
preceded by a
preceded
two. preceded by a two is just the merest bagatelle. They're so, oh, 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 much more I can do. My newfound friend, why, what good is money except to bring salvation to the sorry vale of tears?
My newfound friend, I'll take your sacred money, and soon you'll share the glory when the theater bursts with cheers.
Hello, old friend. Hello, Mr. Broadway. You ain't seen nothing yet. We're gonna tear the town apart. Hello, old friend. We're bringing back to Broadway an Oscar Jaffe classic that's commercial, yet it's art. Five zeros. Preceded by a two, preceded by a dollar sign, is two, oh, 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 wonderful words.
Well, that sounds good, doesn't it? Sounds like Oscar Jaffe is winging back to Broadway with Lily Garland. But remember earlier in the program I told you that same Mrs. Primrose who wrote the check is a nut? Well, it's true. And in this number, the rest of the train discovers her terrible secret.
She's a nut. She's a nut. Mrs. Primrose is a nut.
She's a nut. She's a nut. Mrs. Primrose is a nut.
She's a nut, she's a nut, Mrs. Primrose is a nut.
Mrs. Primrose is a nut, but it's a lie, it's a lie. She's as sane as you or I.
She's a nut, she's a nut, she's a real religious nut. It's a very sad case, it's a very sad case. It's a very sad case, it's a very sad case. She's the one who put up the sick curse. She's the one who put up the sick curse.
Repent for the time is.
Repent for the time is.
Repent for the time is at hand.
She's a nut, she's a nut,
Mrs. Primrose is a nut.
Mrs. Primrose is a nut, but it's a lie, she's as sane as you or I.
She's a nut, she's a nut, she's a real religious nut. She's the one who put up the stickers. She's the one who put up the stickers.
Repent for the time is.
Repent for the time is.
Repent for the time is at hand. Oh, no, oh, 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 five zeros. Alone without the two. Alone without the dollar sign is zero. Zero.
No, 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 no.
It's a very sad case. We're a very sad case. We're a very sad case. She's a nut. She's a nut, Mrs. Primrose is a nut.
Mrs. Primrose is a nut, but it's a lie, it's a lie. She's as sane as you or I.
She's a nut,
she's a nut,
she's a real religious nut.
She's the one who put up the stickers.
She's the one who put up the stickers. She escaped from a mental institution, and her nephews and these officers to come and take her off the train.
Oh, no, no, not Mrs. Primrose.
Oh, yes, 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 Mrs. Primrose. We are back in a state of destitution, cause her check is made of rubber and her hopes are slipping down the drain.
No, 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 not Mrs. Primrose.
Oh, yes, 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 Mrs. Primrose is a nut. She's a nut.
But.
It's a very sad case. It's a very sad case.
Let us know the second that you see her.
She's a nut. She's a nut. Mrs. Primrose is a nut.
Mrs. Primrose is a nut. But it's a lie. It's a lie. She's as sane as you or I.
She's a nut. She's a nut. She's a real religious nut.
What will become of my boogie? What will become of my boogie? Wait till I get my hands on Oscar. Wait till I get my hands on him.
She's a nut. She's a nut.
Well, Oscar Jaffe's funding goes up in smoke as Mrs. Primrose is sent to the loony bin. So Lily Garland is left to contemplate starring in a vehicle produced by Oscar Jaffe's rival, Max Jacobs. Max Jacobs! That's what he would always turn himself into a ball of anger when he heard that. Here is the show she is presented with. It's a Somerset Maugham comedy called Babette, comedy of manners called Babette. And Kristin Chenoweth does a fantastic job dancing and singing and joking around in the current revival. But I will always have a very soft spot for the inimitable Madeline Kahn from the original cast. Here she is.
Max, I've got to reread this play, Babette. Get Oscar and the Mary Magdalene play out of my mind. An evening late in June, a formal dinner at Babette's. The talk is sharp and swift, and yet the atmosphere is fraught with tension. Everyone is there. Corrupt and debonair. A Mayfair set convention. Babette speaks. I gave this small soiree to tell you all the shrieking news. I'm leaving Romney's bed. The joke is that I'm also leaving Nigel. What a shabby lot. Bedecked with jewels between two fools. All hope is gone, the dance goes on and make the music hot. Rodney speaks. Babette, if you think that you can throw away, and so on, so on, so on, so on, so on. Nigel speaks. Well, Babette, this charade will have to end, and so on, so on, so on, so on. Rodney, why, you filthy swat, and so on, so on, so on, so on. And the guests chatter, and so on, so on, so on, so on, so on. Babette! My cigarette is out. Oh, Rodney, please get me a light. I need another drink. She sneers and hurls her glass of gin at Nigel. What a shabby lot. I'll get away to Saint-Tropez. In gin and bitters, drown my jitters.
Lily, forget Babette. You'll be magnificent as Mary Magdalene.
Yes. Take your wine away. Reborn am I today. Redemption. Our sins will be forgiven. And we shall be... No. I need another drink. I think I'd like a sip of champagne. Or better still, a sort of cocaine. Or better still, let us seek salvation. My cigarette is out. The gin is never strong enough. I live for endless loving, boozing, dancing, cruising. We shall be saved. Boozing, dancing, cruising. We shall be saved. Rodney, Nigel, Rodney, boozing, dancing, cruising. We shall be. My cigarette is saved. My cigarette is saved. My cigarette is saved. Where are you, Rodney, Nigel, Nigel, Rodney, Rodney, Nigel? Oscar, 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 Oscar. Oscar. Goodbye, Oscar. Goodbye, Mary Magdalene.
Max, I love your play. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Max, I'll do this play. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Madeline Kahn. Well, John Cullum as Oscar Jaffe realizes he's got one card left to play, which is an attempted suicide to get Lily to sign the contract to come back to Broadway. So here in a great 11 o'clock number is John Cullum saying goodbye to his pals. In the current revival, they kind of potchke around with it and put in new lyrics. I don't know why. It's a great number done fantastically by John Cullum, one of my heroes, at the climax of On the 20th Century.
You may feel bad for a while, but it's better far this way. For I am much too good a showman to dwindle like a snowman melting down one sunny day. My office once overflowed with celebrities galore. I ruled Broadway like a king, but now what lies in store? Oh, boys, can't you see it? Oh, God, I can see a lonely shuffling figure haunting Schubert Alley. It's Crazy Oscar, hear them cry. Get Officer O'Malley. I meant no harm. Please help me up. Where are my pencils? Where are my cup? Oh, thank you, lad. I'll move along. Pencils. Pencils. My pencils. Crazy Oscar's song. You wouldn't want to see me that way. Boys, I know when I've had my day. My story ends. The drama's through. I leave my worldly possessions to you. To you I leave my cape and my fedora. To you I leave my mustache wax. To you I leave an ostrich fan from Floridora. To you I leave my unpaid income tax. To you I leave my bust of Henry Irving. To you I leave my headache pills. To you my set of Theodore Dreiser, my portrait of the Kaiser, and a 10-foot stack of unpaid bills. And when you hear a lonely whistle blowing some future time while riding through the night, could be that whistle is your dear departed Oscar calling. Boys, let's meet at Luke's house for a bite. To you I leave my Japanese kimono. To you I leave my cane and spats. To you I leave a worn-out record of Ramona. To you I leave my gravy-stained cravat. To you I leave my letters to the critics. To you I leave a large false nose. To you my bowl of red wax cherries, a wig of Ellen Terry's, and some ticket stubs from Amy's Irish Rose. Boys, dry your eyes. I don't want to see you weeping. I want smiles and pride in the memories of your association with me. And someday, in the future, when you're feeling low, I want you to go to your closet. And when you open that closet door, take out my cape and take out my fedora. And put them on and think of me. And call to mind my charismatic aura and the legacy I left to him.
John Cullum as Oscar Jaffe in On the 20th Century. Well, as I said earlier, it's one of, if not my favorite shows. It's got a great score by Cy Coleman, fabulous lyrics by Biddy Comden and Adolph Green. How could they be anything else? And you finally get a chance to see it again on 42nd Street. Take your train or your bus or your subway or fly to the American Airlines Theater to see this rare revival of On the 20th Century. It's extended to July. Maybe it'll move. Got great reviews. Maybe it'll win a Tony or two and bring Oscar and Lily back to Broadway. So, of course, it all ends happily. Oscar and Lily realize they can't live without each other. Perhaps they can't live with each other, but they're going to try. And they move to Broadway and sign a contract. And in the great screwball tradition, everything works out. And why shouldn't it all work out? Because they are on that magical train, that musical comedy heaven called On the 20th Century. This is Larry Maslon. Thank you for joining me on this ride for one of my favorite shows. Here is the finale. Enjoy it. Where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.